Your call sounded urgent.
With good reason. I've analyzed the alien's DNA. There are 47 genetic markers identical to those found in human DNA.
That's more than coincidence.
I thought so, too. I ran a search for those markers in Earth's paleontological database. Take a look at this.
Incredible.
That's one way of putting it.
It says here that those markers appeared in hundreds of Earth species, dating back tens of millions of... Their species evolved on Earth?
Apparently so. And from the look of it, you and he are distant cousins.
I wonder how distant. Transfer yourself to Holodeck 2. I think it's time we took a stroll through primeval history.
I've entered the genetic markers into the Holo database.
Let's see if we can find our closet relative. Computer, analyze the genetic markers and search Earth's fossil record. Identify any ancestors common to both humans and the alien in Sickbay.
Life form found.
Display.
Genus, Areops. Devonian era.
Areops? This creature lived over 400 million years ago and is thought to be the last common ancestor of cold-blooded and warm-blooded organisms.
Yes, yes. Let's take the next step in our little stroll. Computer, what's the most highly evolved cold-blooded organism to develop from the Areops?
Genus, Hadrosaur. Cretaceous era.
Display the life form. As I recall, the Hadrosaur vanished when a mass extinction occurred at the end of the Cretaceous period. What if the Hadrosaur didn't die off? What if some of them survived that extinction and continued to evolve?
I could well imagine this creature giving rise to a more complex life form. Certainly the building blocks are there. Bipedal, grasping hands.
Computer, run a genome projection algorithm. If the Hadrosaur had continued to evolve over the last 65 million years, extrapolate the most probable appearance.
Extrapolation complete.
Display life form.
That creature napping in sickbay is a dinosaur.
Question is, why have we never seen him in the natural history museums?